Hello everyone, I am Prancho and welcome to my channel. So finally, the most requested and most awaited video on my channel is here. Today, we are going to take the first step to convert the model that we designed in Fusion 360 in our previous video of ROS-based automated robot, shortly named as ORO, and going to convert it into URDF that we will later use in ROS simulation, as well as we are eventually going to make a real robot out of it. We will be doing it using a plugin designed for Fusion 360 by an indie developer, Toshinori Kitamura, and then tune some parameters of our robot according to our requirements to simulate the robot as close to real world physics as possible. We are going to take this first step by installing this plugin, which is named Fusion2URDF, as it obviously converts Fusion 360 files into URDF onto our PC. This video includes the installation procedure for this plugin on both Windows and macOS. But let's first start by checking out the GitHub page of this plugin. So as I mentioned, this plugin was developed by Toshinori Kitamura, and you can find this on his GitHub ID Syntoku14. He also made this plugin open source, so any creator can modify and contribute to this project. Just like I contributed, and now you can see me in the contributors list. Also, I am still working on this repo and making some constant changes to make it even better. So you can find the updated repo on my GitHub ID as well. Let's first start by installing this plugin for macOS, as it is much more easier. First, open up Finder and navigate to your home directory, which should be labeled with your username. There, if you go into the applications folder, you will see Fusion 360 app installed. If you don't find Fusion 360 here, then you may find it into the root applications folder. If you can find Fusion 360 in the root application folder, then uninstall it and install it again in the home directory, or else you may need to change few commands while installation later on. If you have it installed in applications folder in your username directory, like I have, then go into your username directory and press Command Shift and dot, which will show all the hidden folders and files. Find a folder named Library and go inside Application Support and into Autodesk, where you will find Library folder of Autodesk Fusion 360. If you open it and go into API, you will find place where you can put your plugin scripts, which may be built in Python, C++ or JS. This is the place where our plugin will be installed. To install the plugin, open up the GitHub repo and download the zip. macOS will automatically unzip it. If not, then you can unzip it manually. You can open it in Finder to check out its contents. The important part of this repository is the URDF exporter folder. You need to copy this folder in the scripts folder inside the API of Fusion 360. Either you can do it manually, or there is even a much more simple way to do it. Simply open up your macOS terminal and navigate to your Fusion 2URDF folder. I have mine in the downloads folder, so I will type cd, which stands for change directory, and then downloads/fusion2urdf master, and hit enter. Now I am inside the folder. I can check it by typing the ls command, and it will give me the contents of this folder. Now open the GitHub repo and simply copy the command that is given on the second line, which uses cp command, which is a copy paste command, and paste it into your terminal. Hit enter and it's done. If you now go and check out the API folder and then open scripts, you will find the same URDF exporter folder has been pasted over here. With this done, now you have Fusion 2URDF plugin installed on your Mac. You can now open Fusion 360 app and go into Tools, Add-ins, and find Python script of URDF exporter here. If you want to install this plugin on your Windows PC, the procedure is somewhat similar. Just download the zip of the repo. You can save it wherever you want, but just be aware of the location. Once you have downloaded the zip, unzip or extract all of its contents. You can delete the original zip file, as we only need the unzipped folder. Open the unzipped folder and go inside until you find the URDF exporter folder. Just like in macOS, we have to copy this folder into the EPI location of Fusion 360. But to do that, we will be needing Windows PowerShell. Please note that this is not a normal command prompt. It is a Windows PowerShell. You can search it by typing power into your search bar and then open it. Now copy the location of the folder where you have URDF exporter folder and type in the cd command in the PowerShell, which stands for change directory, followed by the copied path, and press enter. But this gives me an error just because I had a space in my path. So to fix that, we can type the same cd command, but this time the path should be written in quotes. Now you can see your terminal has been sent to that specific location. You can check it by typing dir command, which is directory command, just like we have ls command in Linux and macOS, which lists down all the directories in the given folder. Here you should be able to see URDF exporter folder. Now paste the second command given in the readme of Fusion2URDF repo, and this should copy the URDF exporter folder in the scripts folder of API of Fusion 360. Unless you have space in your Windows username, or else you have kept the location of Fusion 360 something different from the original location, then you may encounter an error. In both of these cases, you can modify the command as I am doing it here right now by replacing the app data by the location where you have installed Fusion 360 and then press enter. If you don't get any error, that means Fusion2URDF plugin is properly installed. You can check it by opening Fusion 360 software and go into Tools Add-ins, where you will find URDF Exporter Python script. So if the process went smooth enough for you, then don't forget to give a like to this video. And if it didn't, even then like this video and make sure to leave a comment telling whatever problem you faced, and I will be there to solve all your queries. In the next video, we will see how we can use this plugin to convert a Fusion 360 design into a URDF and use it in Gazebo. So make sure you are subscribed to the channel and ring the bell icon so that you don't miss out on that video. I hope this video was useful and you have learned something new. And until next time, peace. In parameters according to our requirement of this plugin API of Fusion 360 and make sure 360 design into a U. We'll see how we can use this plugin to convert a